In a recent episode of Minecraft Hacked, I talked about three different hacks as if they were new, but apparently they were already known. This was the reach hack, the cat teleport exploit, and the velocity exploit. Lame. Well, last episode we talked already about the reach hack, so in this one I want to address the cat coordinate exploit. Apparently, the cat coordinate exploit was already known from 2b2t, and it's actually exploiting the teleportation of the cat, not the lookat method as I claimed. Huh, let's investigate. There is a famous 2b2t tamed cat or dog coordinate exploit. Apparently on 2b2t, if you find a tamed cat or dog which is sitting and you pour water on it, it teleports away to the owner. And apparently you get sent the target entity location with the teleport entity packet. So simply by making a tamed animal port to their owner, you will know where it teleported to, which obviously is an easy coordinate exploit. But I don't know what to tell you. It doesn't work on 1.19.2, or at least doesn't work on the paper server. Actually, you made me so insecure about it that I even went back and tested it again. Let me show you. Here I extended my hacking mod with a packet logger where I can log incoming and outgoing packets. And then I created a super flat world with basically no distractions and started setting up the experiment. Which means I took a bunch of cats and tamed them. First of all, the first part of the tamed animal coordinate exploit still works. When a cat is sitting, it doesn't teleport away. The reason for that is the code I showed you last episode. When a cat was ordered to sit, the AI goal to follow the owner cannot be started. So we never reach the AI code where it decides to teleport to the owner. However, pouring water over a cat makes the cat suddenly change their AI. And I think it's this function in living entity, the herd function. When a cat is underwater and is running out of air, the herd method is called, which can lead to the cat changing their order to sit state. Suddenly, they are not sitting anymore, which means the AI goal to follow the owner can be executed and they teleport away. So far, so good. But there is no teleport packet sent to the player who witnesses the teleport. I tested this. Again, let me show you. Here we have the test setup with tamed cats, and with another client I stole a cat in a boat. As we know, if the cat is on a boat or on a leash, the AI goal is never entered, so it doesn't teleport away. Now I'm activating the packet logging of incoming packets, and we see constantly packets about some entities, maybe the cat or maybe the boat. Let's destroy the boat and the cat disappears, teleports back to the owner. We can now have a look at the packets that were received during this test. One of them should be the mysterious teleport packet, right? Let me clean it up, only look at the unique packets. So those are all the kind of packets we received. We got a block update, probably because I accidentally punched the ground, but here are a few entity related packets which we can look up on wiki.vg to see which one contains coordinates. Maybe one of them leaked the teleport location. Knowing the possible packets, I can also implement a bit more verbose logging. Basically, I go through every potential packet and print the data included. So for example, when we get an entity position packet, we print the X, Y, and Z coordinate. Or when we get just an entity packet, the packet contains relative coordinates and I print that too, indicated by the squiggly line. Anyway, let's just run the experiment with more verbose logging again, stealing another cat and flying far away. Preparing the packet logging, and now you can see actual coordinates printed of entities. By the way, we are roughly at around -590-ish, and the owner of the cat is located at around 0. So let's see. Destroy the boat, cat teleported away, and let's copy out the packet trace to have a closer look. So we get a few entity packets with 0. Is that the location of the owner? Well, obviously not. These are relative coordinates. The owner is not exactly at 0, 0. Also, Y would have to be -60. And as mentioned before, squiggly lines, these are relative coordinates. So here is no movement at all. If you would see, however, some numbers around positive 600, so from our current position minus 600 to get to 0, we would need a delta movement of plus 600, then it would leak the location, but there is no such packet. And all the other entity position packets are from the area here, minus 618 and so forth. They are probably the other animals that spawned around here. As you can see, at least with paper 1.19.2, this does not leak the coordinate of the owner when a tamed animal teleports to them. This is maybe an old bug on 2b2t, but not on modern Minecraft. So let's come back to the cat coordinate exploit that was used to find me. As far as I know, this was a novel bug. It does not abuse a teleport packet. Instead, it exploits the fact that the cat sometimes looks at the direction of the owner, and by keeping the cat leashed, you can still make it look into that direction. Now, if the cat is sitting, it doesn't work, so you have to force the cat to change its sitting state with water, but you don't want it to teleport away. You really need to be careful, and that's why you leash it. This will still cause the cat to look into the direction, but never teleport. So to me, this is still an unknown and novel bug in Minecraft. I know that PixelPro discovered this himself. You can pause and read the summary of how it was discovered here. But of course, others might have discovered it before and we just don't know about it. In that case, please send me some links or documentation about that. I always find this very interesting. But either way, it definitely is not the 2b2t teleport exploit like everyone was saying. And I guess it is my fault for not properly explaining that in the episode. So now we are here. Cats revealed the location of my base, and then somebody decided to redecorate the base in a different style, and I don't think it looks really cool, so I obviously have to find a new spot. But if I go to a different spot, how can I protect my location? I have no clue where all the cats are that I tamed. So in order to protect my location, I added this code to the server plugin, the cats suck class. On a timer, it occasionally checks all loaded entities, whether they are tameable. I loop over all of them, and if I'm the owner, if they were tamed by me, then I override the owner with this other UUID. Hopefully this will protect my location this time. Now let's come to the community showcase. First one is Tutbutt. What you're looking at here is an Elytra flight 3D pathfinding using a modified A-star algorithm. He added lots of optimizations because A-star is usually horribly slow and essentially unusable since complexity grows extremely quickly per dimension and cave size. And so, for example, the algorithm is crawling along the walls instead of scanning every block. A big challenge was also making it not try to search in unloaded chunks because it's not easy to differentiate between air blocks or just not loaded chunks. Overall, pretty cool, I think. I also love the visualization of the pathfinding. It's kind of relaxing to watch. The next showcase is a cool trick from my sheep challenge. So the intended way to solve it is to spawn the sheep and use a reach hack or TP aura or whatever it's called to kill the sheep far away. However, here they solved it differently using two players. One player triggered the sheep and the other caught it in a boat, quickly teleported with it over to the first player, and then the first player killed it. Listen to them being excited about having pulled it off. Really cool as well.
It worked!
Sheep delivery service.
It is Christmas, and you probably have written some Christmas cards. But as you probably know, you have a shitty handwriting, and these Christmas cards look terrible. That's why you should have used the LiveOverfont. This is a handwritten font created by me, and it would have made your Christmas cards extremely beautiful. So don't do the same mistake again, and next time use the LiveOverFont.